There's no feeling more intense than starting over. If you've broken your Scratch project moments after you've shared it, as I have, or you've spent hours working on a project only to notice too late that one of your sprites has unexplainably gone missing. If you've made use of that difficult-to-name thing of ThingBlock, within the sensing category, amazingly useful, but capable, due to a Scratch bug, of leaving you crying as it dumps all your scripts in one big and ordered heap. If you've made real progress coding a game over the course of the week, only to come back the next day to discover you weren't even logged in. Nothing has been saving. Starting over is harder than starting up. If you're not ready for that, like if you've already had a bad day at school, then what you're about to go through may be too much. Feel free to go away and come back. I'll be here.
Oh man.
All right, you lost a lot of
progress.
Thanks
for coming with me on this trip. I'll understand if you need to take a break at any point.
Whoops.
Just find a safe place to stop and remember to pause the game by pressing P. On Scratch, you can find loads of remixed or reimagined recreations of existing games. And with good reason. George Bernard Shaw said, imitation is not just the sincerest form of flattery. It's the sincerest form of learning.
Not again.
This game is a recreation
Pick yourself up.
That came out in 2017.
Back up you go.
Getting Over It with Bennett Foddy. That game in turn was a homage to a free game that came out in 2002. Both games involved dragging yourself, using a hammer, up a mountain assembled from assets and objects sourced from many other games. It seems appropriate then that, when trying to recreate Getting Over It in Scratch, that we should construct our mountain from the same assets used in literally millions of Scratch projects, the unmistakable contents of the Scratch costume library. Unlike Unity or Unreal, Scratch does not provide you with a built-in physics or 3D rendering engine. It is no state-of-the-art debugger. You can't even pause your scripts. We are forced to program old school. Our experience capped 30 frames per second on a 480 by 360 pixel stage. But these very restrictions force us to experiment, to think out of the box, to grow as developers as we become masters of all things Scratch. And let's not forget, what we lack in technology, we make up for in community. This fantastic bunch of budding software engineers, building, learning, creating, playing, remixing, as diverse a group of people as the very Scratch assets we now so skillfully attempt to ascend. The act of climbing, in the digital world or in the real world, has certain essential properties that give the game its flavour. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed. When you start Getting Over It, you're standing next to a dead tree, which blocks the way to the entire rest of the game. You prod and poke at it, exploring the limits of your reach and strength, trying to find a way up. When starting a new Scratch project, that initial blank slate is both refreshing and at times a little scary. Wouldn't it be great if we could travel forward in time and review our finished projects to see how well they turned out? I certainly wish we could. The real draw of coding, what gives it that special zing, is the challenge of accomplishing something you've never done before. At this point, you don't want to fall into the trap of rushing into creating loads of content, designing all the levels, the player costumes, all the easier stuff that can be perfected later. No, before all that, you need to prod and poke that tree. That is, understanding the coding difficulties you're expecting to face and try out any ideas to solve them. You may not be able to time travel, but at least this way you can get a good idea of how well your project is likely to go, and potentially save yourself a lot of time.
It always seems impossible.
Until, that is, it's done. This project began life a couple of months ago as three simple scripts: the player, hammer, and level. I spent no time on the art, just using ScratchCAD and a few rectangles drawn in the sprite editor. The scripts for the player quickly mocked up in a similar fashion to those I teach on my YouTube channel. With the hammer, I had to improvise because I'd never done anything quite like that before. And boy, did I prod and poke at those scripts. A failure is not always a mistake. It may simply be the best one can do under the circumstances. The real mistake would be to stop trying. Fall 7 times and stand up 8.
all of old. Nothing else ever. Ever tried, ever failed. No matter, try again, fail again, fail better. Success is the sum of small efforts, repeated day in and day out. Many of life's failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. It does not matter how slowly you go on, as long as you do not stop. Perseverance is the hard work you do after you get tired of doing the hard work you already did. Success seems to be largely a matter of hanging on when others have let go. Discouragement and failure are two of the surest stepping stones to success. You never know what's around a corner. It could be everything, or it could be nothing. You keep putting one foot in front of the other, and then one day, as you look back, you've climbed the mountain. A winner is just a loser who's tried one more time. Defeat is not